Remember at the South Shore Theater Experience. Tonight, we've put together a concert in honor of Matthew Lightsey, who we tragically lost earlier this year. Today would have actually been his 23rd birthday. Matthew was full of energy, joy, music. He had so much to offer the world and never stopped pursuing his dreams. He was a singer, songwriter, playwright, director, actor, performer, and most of all, he was the most fun and loving person you could know. The music tonight is a compilation of songs that he wrote along with his best friend, John Paul Lewis. Some of them are from the show Matthew wrote a few years ago called The Composer's Melody, which he wrote, directed, and acted in twice. Others are from other projects, and I'm sure John would love to tell you more little snippets on how they came to be. I hope that tonight we can express all the love we have for Matthew by showing you some of his music. This is a part of his legacy, and that legacy will live on in our hearts always. Thank you, and enjoy the show.
The first song that we're going to be playing is called Hypothetically. This was the second song that Matt and I ever wrote. He wrote the lyrics, and he gave them to me to write the music to, and I remember just being so inspired by the lyrics that I just couldn't help but write this music to it. In the show, it's the second song that the main character sings, and it's about pursuing his dreams.
Yeah.
hypothetically. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. The next song that we are going to perform is called Battle for the Ages. It's from the same show, and it's about two girls that hate each other because they like the same guy, which happens sometimes. So both of these people played, humans played, played Caroline. We're going to introduce Christina, how do you say your last name again?
Cotignola.
Cotignola, Christina Cotignola, here we go. Everyone give her a hand. Let's give a hand for Emily Vane, who also played Caroline.
Wait, you played Caroline.
Yeah, obviously. Okay, well, I was the original, so.
The remix was better.
Oh, good!
We'll see about that.
Okay.
This girl is such a fucking bitch. Does she think an ass equals a texted them to me, and I was like, sure, okay, and then I just kind of came up with this in like 4 hours, and then I recorded it, and I sent it to him at like 3 a.m, and then he was like, he loved it, and I sent it to the guy, Claude, who actually wrote the script, and he loved it too, and so we're going to perform it for you guys now.
Are you lost? Have you forgotten? Find a home. What's the cost to prove that I'm not leaving you? With you gone, I can't help but say goodbye to you.
the greatest singer I've ever met in my life, Genevieve. How do you say your name?
Genevieve Fevre.
Matt and I wrote this song in like an hour, actually. He was writing the lyrics as I was writing them, because we couldn't find a song for the lead girl in the show. And we just somehow one day just got together and we came up with this. And Matt actually did hear her sing a couple of times, several months back, or a couple, like probably a year back, and always wanted her to sing our music because he thought you were incredible, and because you are.
I mean, this songwriting is incredible. It really allows me to open up.
Sharon, my love. There's a train I wanted, and I know this might sound crazy, but at night I fly with the stars. Listen, I cannot lie, and I know this might sound lazy, but I'm afraid to fall. I will work from afar as a sled flies past the stars. I am with you, Sharon. Sitting at the piano, finding the chords and singing stuff, and he would just be so excited. So he would stand over me with this excitement. I just could feel the energy. And then sometimes it would just hit the right spot where you're just like, okay, this is like the thing we need. And so we wrote this in like an hour. Again, like it was just, and he added these amazing harmonies that I wouldn't have thought of. And Eugenia actually sang, it was Alice in the show, and she did a great job, so.
You should know that life for me been playing the same days on repeat, but you're different and I can't explain just how. In your eyes I'm lost in the clouds.
I think you should know I'm bad with my words along with other things. I can't sing, but you're different.
Show, there's a cowboy in the show named Claude. What's the name of the cowboy? Do you remember? Little Willie or something. And Matt wrote this song. He presented it to me, and it's like the funniest thing ever. But it's so catchy and so good. And I just arranged it, but it was just I wanted to play this just to present to you the type of songwriting that he would do on his own. So.
But I don't mean that in a sarcastic way
whatsoever. I think it's really, really good.
So I'm gonna do this opening.
Hopefully, I don't screw it up. So colorful, but now you shriek, please, please come and help us. And I say, hey, it's okay. I'm just that wonderful scrub.
You are.
They're all coming from New York City. New York City, baby. So the next song that we're going to be performing is called I Want You to Know. And the way this song was written is I was listening to a piece by Franz Liszt. And I heard these chords that I thought were one of the most beautiful chords I've ever heard in my life. And so I learned them. And then I started to write a melody over it. And I presented it to Matt. And I had the verse and the chorus. And we finished it together. And it's one of my favorite songs. And yeah. I want to introduce Zach Aratakis here. Who sang in the original show, The Composer's Melody. He played Trevor and has known Matt for a number of years and taught him a variety of different things about music and life. And I want to also introduce Chrissy Menfee, who played Jezebel in the second edition of the show. So I thought it might be nice to bring them together because they're amazing singers.
Visions of my days.
next song we'll be performing is the first song ever that Matt and I ever performed together in high school at the acoustic night. We both really like Ben Folds, and I don't know who suggested to cover this, but we both liked the song, and I remember coming to my house every single day and just rehearsing these harmonies over and over and over again, just constantly until we got them right. And I wouldn't perform with Matt for many years after that, but that I think was the spark of our creative endeavor. So I'd like to perform that song for you now.
Fred sits alone at his desk in the dark. There's an awkward young shadow who waits in the hall. He has cleared all his things and he's put them in boxes. Things that remind him that life has been good. 25 years he's worked at the paper.
Amalgamation of different songs combined together to create one giant song. And what the band did with this in terms of the arrangement, because I never arranged it before, was stunning to me. And I'm very excited to perform it for you guys now. Some people can relate to that. Dreams and destiny wait out the window. Those who think they know have told you go. But what if you're not ready for your dream? Well, sure as hell, don't let it run away. Run away, run away, run away. But now, I grabbed the words, hold on. Where'd you get that? I don't wanna chase that dream.
thought I was gonna have a clean run.
Take two.
I forgot the words.
There you go, John.
Fuck.
Woo!
Do you have the words on it?
It doesn't have the words.
Shit.
Improv.
Yeah. What my mom used to say to me. Oh! That's like my mom used to say to me.
Alright, we'll start that again.
Okay.
Sorry, everyone. Dreams and destiny wait out the window. Those who think they know, I told you so. But what if you're not ready for your dreams? Well, sure as hell, don't let it run away. Lyrics, and he had this this melody, and it was originally for this this John Wilkes Booth show that we were working on. And the context of the scene was basically John dying and saying goodbye to his brother Edwin. And I remember at the time thinking, like, this is one of the most beautiful things he's ever written. And I remember saying, I don't really remember him playing the piano part. And I was just like, Matt, I got it. And so he just started singing, and I just listened to the melody and the chords, and I found the right chords for it. And then we did this in about, again, an hour, recorded it, and
going to release it at some point. I recorded strings to it, but yeah, I just wanted to present it to you, to all now. The next two songs I'm going to be performing
are songs I... Does this go higher, Brian?
Oh, yeah, it definitely does. I'm just an idiot.
Okay, John, I have to... It's okay, we're idiots together.
Yay.
John, you twist it.
I know you twist it. I'll twist you, brother. I'm kidding. I love you, Mark. Songs that I wrote for and about what happened. They're a little dark, I apologize for that. Oh shit. I gotta tune my guitar. Every day I try, fighting to survive, but will I cross that line? I just wanna give in, I just wanna give in. Tell me how it feels, this doesn't seem real,
just wanna give in. Lost in time.
want to thank everyone coming here tonight. It means a lot to me. I love you, Matt. Thank you everyone for coming tonight. It means the world to me, and I know that he would have loved to hear all this music with these incredible musicians. I'm gonna make it my life mission to continue making music and to share the music him and I did to the day I die. Thank you, everyone. Everyone. I want to thank you, Alan, so much. You've been such a great friend, and you're an incredible musician and songwriter. You've given me so many opportunities, and I love you. And Dave, you're such a brilliant, brilliant guy, and such an incredible musician and a good friend. And I'm honored to play with you. And Colin, you're such a great guy and an incredible musician. I'm absolutely honored to play with these guys. Thank you, everyone. Have a good rest of your night.